My name is Andrew Sparrow, and I'm a smart manufacturing nut. Here's how one of the leading Agile MES leaders goes about proving others wrong in delivering now over 300 MES MOM projects.
The last 7 years, I've probably done close to 300 projects.
Oh, wow. And then one day, I met James Montgomery of Ondair, arguably one of the most experienced MOM system integrators around today.
The whole idea of Agile is to get started.
Andrew Sparrow, smart manufacturing nut. I am here with James Montgomery from Ondair Corp. James is the director of North American operations. James, it's a pleasure. Let's get started. What is manufacturing operations management all about to you?
MOM, as we like to call it, it's all parts of manufacturing, not just the production piece that people are used to in MES, but more around the warehouse, the quality, supply chain,
yeah,
time and labor, maintenance, everything that goes into producing the right part.
Okay, and what do you think are the key benefits for the business of implementing the MES solution?
Visibility and control, breaking stuff down into manageable chunks, having visibility to the floor, making
yep.
sure you can see what you're doing, integrating with like the machines, making sure things are being done correctly.
Okay, and if you were then to take all of those integration on the shop floor level, how important is it to integrate within the product lifecycle, within the ERP, within the supply chain applications as well?
Super important. They're the major building blocks of your manufacturing thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
You've got to make sure that you have all those things. It's the skeleton to build the execution upon. Having that is super important. Getting the stuff down from the PLM, the characteristics that can help you define your manufacturing process is super important.
Great.
At the same time, having it feedback, like feeding the real-time information back is super important. Keeping your ERP up to date so that your MRP runs, scheduling demand, making sure that that is all real time or real time as possible means that you're more accurate and you're getting stuff done more accurately.
Welcome back, Andrew Sparrow, smart manufacturing nut. I am here with James Montgomery from Ondair Corp. And James, of course, is the director of North American operations and a real MES Agile expert. Let's go there. Okay, so James, what is Agile and how do you relate that to MES implementation specifically?
Agile is basically a style of development, software development, that's been around for many, many years.
Yep.
Basically, a lot of people think it's a guideline or set of rules. It's actually just a way of thinking about doing software development, following basically 12 core principles, and maybe we could put something on the screen here to show
yeah.
those 12 core.
Okay.
But basically, it's about getting stuff done fast, being agile in how you're getting stuff out to the business, and the aim is to get something that's valuable and usable to the business as fast as possible.
Right. And why would you use Agile for an MES implementation specifically?
100% that benefit, right? The sooner you get something in someone's hands, the more they can understand how it works, the feedback. You can do it. Some people are just touch people, right? They
yeah.
like to get their hands on
yep.
it. They like to see it working. And then they start understanding how it works and start giving you the real requirements and moving it in a way that's going to move the needle for them.
That's great. And who do you see as being the key people involved? Who's part of that team in this whole
sure.
MES implementation?
Yeah, it depends. Like a lot of people have scrum masters and all that. You need that project manager style person that can do it. It's not about key people. It's roles that are fulfilled. Some people can do multiple roles. The most important thing is you have the developers,
yeah.
some QA, always quality forward, right? You've got to make sure what you're producing is high quality. But having a scrum master, having the devs QA internally, right? But then externally, making sure you have the key business personnel there, having someone that can make sure the business is ready to move forward is super important. Making sure that what you're producing is going to be used and is making sure you have the right people from the business, having them there. If they're there and they're helping you get that, you could have the best system in the world, but if you don't have the business behind it
yep.
and some representatives, hopefully at a higher level to help make the changes, then you're in trouble. So having that key business person is, or
good.
Key business people is essential.
Great. Welcome back, Andrew Sparrow, Smart Manufacturing Nut. Here with James Montgomery, who is head of North American operations, director of North American operations for Ondair Corporation. MOM Consulting, hey?
Lovely.
Good. So, question up for you. How successful have Agile projects been in your experience in MES?
How successful?
Mm-hmm.
Initially, not so much.
Okay.
It was...
when did you first start?
Probably about 7 years ago.
Okay, okay.
It was kind of forced on me, my last company. They said you got to start following Agile. It was done in a very haphazard way. They just told us to read some books on Agile that was utilizing Jira to do it. They're giving us the tools, and it was very follow the rules of Agile. And the first project, I was frustrated. We were using story points instead of estimates. Completely went against the way I was doing things. And the end result was that project went late. I was frustrated. The business owners were frustrated. The developers were frustrated. Everyone was frustrated.
Okay. So, because, you know, I meet a lot of manufacturing guys, and the vast majority go, you can't do Agile MES.
That's
why
not
is that?
That's not, I think because the way about Agile is you've got to, the whole idea of Agile is to get started and get stuff out to the business as fast as possible. And make it valuable software.
Yep.
And start moving the needle for the business.
Mm-hmm.
To do that often means starting without a complete vision. It means starting without an end date that's probably not known.
Yeah.
Not a complete set of requirements.
Okay.
So it frustrates them. It goes against what the manufacturing world was not like that, right?
Yeah.
You did your designs, you did you took it to the engineers took it to the production people, and you build engineers and so on.
Mm-hmm.
It goes against that. So I think there's a lot of uncertainty, a lot of lack of visibility, and there's a lack of vision for these guys that they need. So that's frustrating for them. I get it. I understand.
So how would you go about improving the way Agile MES is done? I mean, you've been through a number of them. How many have you been through now?
Probably the last 7 years, I've probably done close to 300 projects.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah.
So you've learned some pretty hard mistakes.
Lots of mistakes.
What would you do to improve Agile MES projects now?
Make sure you got the business involved.
Okay.
Make sure you, like a lot of people think starting Agile, you just put your finger to the wind and go. It's not true. You've got to do it up front. It's all about comfort. Is the business comfortable with you going? Is everyone on the same page? Are your developers involved? Have you taken them out to see the problem? Once you start aware of the problem, what you want to do, and the business is ready, then you just go and you crank. You try to get as much as you can down. The best disinfectant is sunlight. Like I say, as soon as I give you something to play with, it's amazing how much a system takes shape and goes off in different tangents once people touch it. Because once you see what they can do, how it does it, people get creative.
Yeah.
So keeping the system and the business in alignment as much as possible is key. Remember that Agile is not a set of rules. It's not a guideline. It's not a methodology. Really, it's the manifesto, right? It's about making sure that you believe that you can constantly improve how you're developing and getting stuff out. Not only not being agile with what you're building, but how you're doing it. And the closer you are with manufacturing to do it, so they're agile with you and you keep in sync, no more than 3 months out of what they need either side, that's when the magic happens. When you and the business create a true partnership and are getting stuff done, great things happen.
Yep. So in essence, it's really optimizing your production. It is bringing the business on board to better ways of doing things at speed. So you can start keeping up with what's going on in the fourth industrial revolution.
Keep trying. Experiment, push, like make sure you've got a path. Make sure you can see the vision and work to that. Work together and you can create some really good things. And when people start using it and they start seeing that you can be agile, a lot of people don't even bother going with projects because they think, it's going to take me a year and a half, 2 years, $2 million, whatever.
Yep.
If you can start getting stuff, small changes out that move the needle in incremental ways, then you start getting momentum and things really take shape.
Right. Thanks, James. Appreciate it.
Lovely.
So what is the key benefit of MES Agile? What are you doing right now to really bring a benefit to the business?